of the perks of working at the record plant is meeting Rose Mann-Cherney, a truly unique figure in the modern recording industry. As the First Lady of LA's record plant, she is also the first woman president of a major recording studio, and for many years has shined brightly as a beacon for women throughout the music industry.
Rose will bless you, she'll scold you, she'll let you know your place, but she'll always sprinkle it with love and encouragement to do better, and she'll make you want to just do the best you can.
In the studio, a place Don Was describes as a cauldron of chaos, Rose has an uncanny ability to psych out the situation, analyze the requirements, define the parameters, and make the client feel like they have a comfortable home for their project. This living room atmosphere originated at the record plant and is now a standard of studio life. Rose perfected it.
She saved many records. She probably saved my career. She saved my health in ways that I'm not even aware of. She's always standing there behind the scenes, making sure that things don't go off the rails.
I just wanted to wish you congratulations and send my love. And you've just done so much for this industry, blazing a trail for women and showing how it's done with so much class and perseverance, your sense of humor and your rock and roll spirit intact. You've helped so many people get to where they are, including me, and we had such a great time. You made such a family situation for Nick of Time for mixing that. The record's always going to have you as part of our legacy.
Young Rosie got started in the music business in her hometown of Chicago, where her future husband, producer-engineer Ed Cherney, was getting his studio chops together.
She's one of a few women who really made a difference and made the record business better.
She is simply recording industry royalty.
Rose took on the job of booking agent for Dunwich Productions, which focused on artist services. She learned about promotion, management, and most importantly, how to work effectively with artists.
You took studio booking and then studio management, you made it an art, and with that you made Record Plant the most popular studio in the world.
In the 70s, Los Angeles was a hotbed of opportunity, and Rose made the move, where she met the young producer and musician, Al Cooper. He thought she should meet Chris Stone and Gary Kellgren, co-founders of the Record Plant. The studio business was becoming a whole new ballgame, and they needed someone at the front desk who could book sessions and do the things to make it work around the clock. They made Rose an offer, and she agreed to stay for 1 year.
Rose Mann-Cherney, you're the first woman to be inducted into the TEC Awards Hall of Fame. I'm so proud of you. You not only found your niche, girl, you made it all your own. And not only one generation of Simsicks, but now two that you're helping.
Congratulations,
Rose.
Bye.
The winner is the Record Plant.
I've got the best staff in the whole wide world. Without them, this would not happen. All my kids.
Over the years, Rose's dominion has grown with her abilities as a studio manager, a role she helped to define within the Record Plant vision.
Rose's formula has never changed. Fabulous, comfortable facilities, a well-trained and managed staff, combined with technical excellence and the highest level of client service.
The client is welcomed as if to a five-star hotel with personal concierge service and Rose's own style of surprises, like setting up a playpen for an artist's newborn baby. Of course, she has arranged larger playpens for adults as well.
A rose is a rose is a rose. And without this rose, this industry would be nothing.
It all comes down to her unique blend of business skills and people skills. It's one of the rewards of working at the Record Plant. You get to know Rose.
Congratulations, Rose, upon your induction into the TEC Hall of Fame. You are the best of the best.
She is one of a kind, and tonight we are pleased to welcome Rose Mann-Cherney into the TEC Awards Hall of Fame.